fucking music like that.
Be seated. Welcome everyone, and let me be the first to say, wow, the day has finally arrived, and what a beautiful location to have such a beautiful ceremony. Today we take ourselves out of the usual routine of daily living to witness a unique moment in the lives of Westin and Kristin. To all their guests, they're very happy to share this moment with you, because they've known you for most of their years. You've watched them grow up, you went to school with them, you've worked with them, and because you're the ones who have supported them and known them so well, it is only fitting that you are the ones to share this once-in-a-lifetime moment with them. Now I have a very important question for the man that stands before me. Who gives this woman to be married to this man?
I do.
Thank you, sir. And we have gathered together on this day, there we go, on September 17th to witness and celebrate the marriage of Westin and Kristin. We've come together not to mark the start of a relationship, but to acknowledge a relationship that already exists and to strengthen that bond. But it had to start somewhere, right? So when I asked both of them what their very first thoughts were of one another, Westin said, "The first thought I had about Kristin was when I first met her at Reed Nash's house. I was looking at her thinking to myself, I'm going to end up marrying this girl. I know it. And here we are. And by the way, the first thing she thought about me was, dang, that's a nice truck you're driving. And don't let her tell you otherwise. Now, I had to check up on that. I thought he was joking with me, but now that was the truth. That was the truth. She really liked his truck. Because there's something women like about a pickup. Oh, sorry, Christy's response was this. I thought he was very funny and that we were a lot alike. There was an instant connect, and I knew by the end of the night that he was the one. You know, from those very first interactions, they grew into a relationship of love that has brought them together before all of you today. You know, marriage is a commitment in life where people can not just find, but they can bring out the very best in one another. It offers opportunities for sharing and growth that no other human relationship can equal. It's a physical and emotional joining that has a promise of a lifetime. So just a little bit of advice I'd like to give you this afternoon. A good marriage, it must be created. In marriage, the little things, they do become the big things. It's remembering to say that I love you at least once a day. It's never going to sleep angry. It's standing together to face this world and speaking words of appreciation and also demonstrating it in gratitude. It's having the capacity not just to forgive, but also to forget. And here's my favorite one. It's not only marrying the right person, but it's about being the right partner. So Westin and Kristy, the covenant which you're both about to make today for one another is a sacred expression of your love for one another. So do you both come here freely without reservation to enter a marriage as companions, living together as one? Do you promise to love, respect, assist, and look after one another for the rest of your lives? And are you prepared to live in harmony and jointly strive for the welfare of your family? If you both agree, look deeply into each other's eyes and say, we do.
We do.
When I asked them both about what they really love about one another, why are you here today standing in front of your family and your friends saying, I do? Westin said this, I love that Kristy is a genuine person and has the biggest heart. She would do anything for someone. She is quiet, but once you get to know her, she's the best friend you'll ever have. Kristy said this about Westin. I love how smart, loyal, and hardworking he is. Most of all, he's the most selfless, loving person I've ever met and is always there when I need him. You know, after hearing that, it is only fitting that we go into probably the most important part of the day, which is the vows. So Westin and Kristy, I'm going to ask each of you to pledge your intentions to one another before these witnesses with these vows. And I'll ask Westin if you'll just repeat after me that I, Westin,
take you, Kristy,
to be my wife,
to have and to hold,
from this day forward, for better or for worse,
for richer or for poor,
in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish,
until death do us part.
And Kristy, just as that, I'll ask you to do the same. To just repeat after me that I, Kristy,
take you, Westin,
to be my husband, to have and to hold,
from this day forward,
for better or for worse,
for richer or for poor,
in sickness and in health,
to love and to cherish,
till death do us part. You know, it is love in one of its finest forms into which they both now enter into this covenant. I love what Paul says in scriptures and how he talks about what love is. And he says in 1 Corinthians 13, verse 4, that it's patient and kind. That is something very important to understand as you're about to get hit in the head with an acorn. It does not envy and it does not boast. It's not arrogant and it's not rude. And Paul goes on to say it does not insist on its own way. It's not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice at wrongdoing. But what love does, it rejoices with the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never fails. But you know, in every relationship, there are trials. In every relationship, there are struggles. And the marriages at last realize that love is what helps us get through those rough times and those not so pretty moments of marriage. So when I ask both of them, as I do and as I'm accustomed to doing at all weddings, well, what's your pet peeve about one another? What is the thing that you do that just really gets, you know, on the other person's nerves? And Kristy said this about Westin, that the biggest waste of money was buying a clothes hamper because none of his clothes seemed to make it there. I think that's about 99.8% of the guys right there. Westin said, my biggest pet peeve is that I can't figure out why she's always right. And I think you're a very smart man. You're starting off on a good foot. There you go. I was trying to get some dirt on Christy here. But you know, in all marriages, you will find some things that you may not like. But you will also find that in those things, they come from a person that you so deeply love. And that makes those things bearable. Because love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things, love never fails. Now, we're about to exchange the rings, but before we do that, I'm going to ask Westin. Actually, I'm going to ask Christy to take Weston's hands and place them palm up so you can look at his hands. And we have a little of a reading here. And so these are the hands of your best friend. They're sturdy and strong. That are holding yours on your wedding day as he promises to love you all the days of your life. These are the hands that will work alongside yours as together you build your future, as you laugh and as you cry, as you share your thoughts and your dreams. And these are the hands that look so large and strong, yet will be so gentle as he holds your child for the first time. These are the hands that will work diligently for your family and for you. These are the hands that will wipe the tears from your eyes, tears of sorrow, but also tears of joy. These are the hands that will comfort you in illness, and these are the hands that will protect you and care for you at all of the important times of your life. So, Weston, what I'm going to ask you to do is grab Christy's hands now and turn them palm up and look at her hands and look at her and just realize that these are the hands of your best friend holding yours on your wedding day as she pledges her love and commitment to you for all the days of her life. These are the hands that will hold each of your children, soothing them through illness and their hurts, supporting and encouraging them all along the way. These are the hands that will hold you tightly as you struggle through life's difficult times. These are the hands that will comfort you when you're sick and console you when you're grieving. These are the hands that will give you support as she encourages you to chase your dreams. And these are the hands that will love you and cherish you through the years for a lifetime of happiness. Together as a team, life will be fuller, life will be richer. At this time now, I'm going to ask Weston if he'll turn to his best man, Christian, and receive the rings. You got one job, Christian.
I did my job.
There you go. Oh, yeah. The wedding ring, you know, is a symbol of eternity. It's an outward sign of an inward and spiritual bond which unites two people in a constant love. So, Weston, what I'm going to do is ask you to take her ring, place it upon her left hand of her ring finger, and repeat after me. With this ring.
With this ring.
I thee wed.
I thee wed.
Push it on. There you go. You place, get his ring and place upon his left hand of his ring finger and also repeat after me that with this ring.
With this ring.
I thee wed.
I thee wed.
Now because Weston and Christy have consented together in the covenant of marriage and have pledged their faithfulness to one another by giving and receiving each of a ring, by the authority vested in me as a minister according to the laws in the state of Virginia, I now pronounce they are husband and wife together in the sight of God and man. Those that God have joined together, let no man separate. So at this time, Weston, I'm going to get out the way, but you may now kiss your bride. Oh, yeah. Let me be the very first to introduce you. It's my privilege and honor for the very first time, Mr. and Mrs. Weston Browder. Y'all can stand, please.
I said I would be all for you, Dad.
for Steven and Brittany. The moment we've all been waiting for the reintroduction today, ladies and gentlemen, make some crazy noise for Mr. and Mrs. Browder.
Yeah.
up for the couple's first. You guys can go ahead and ready to have the couple's
son, thank you.
Five, ready,
with the wind, these are lights.
So much love in all this place, like there's nobody else in the world. I was enough for them not long ago. I was her number one, she told me so, and she still means the world to me, just so you know. So be careful when you hold my girl. Time changes everything, that much more. I'm not gonna stand in your way. I loved you first, I loved you first, and a place in my heart will always be hers. From the first breath she breathed, when she put a smile on me, but it's still hard to give her away. I loved her first. I knew that a tear before I fall away to you. Be the same pretty face, kid that I knew. One that I read in all those fairy tales straight.
You hit me like a train, first time.
Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for the second father of your day.
First of all, I just want to say I don't do well public speaking, so I'm going to take a shot. If you want to take one with me, you're welcome to. Now that's over with. I want to thank you all for being here today. I just want to say how happy and lucky I am to be here to celebrate Kristin and Weston's wedding with everybody. Today, everything looks effortless. If I haven't had a chance to meet you yet, my name is Brittany. As you could tell my dress, I'm one of the bridesmaids. Kristin and I have been good friends for about 2 years now, and we met at work. When I first met Kristin, I thought she didn't like me because she had an RBF. If you don't know what RBF means, it means resting bitch face. Well, since I suffer from the same RBF symptom, I took that as a challenge to make new friends. Little did I know she'd be one of the sweetest, most caring, genuine people in my life today. It all started with venting about some office drama, then realizing how much we had in common. We've gotten so close the last couple of years. Not only has she become one of my best friends, but she's come family to me. My wish for everyone here is that I hope you all have a Kristin in your life. I feel so blessed that God has brought her into my life. And Kristin talked about Weston all the time. When I finally met him, I understood why she was, he said she was the one, he was the one. Chrissy's face lights up every time she talks about Westin. When I see them both together, I love the way Westin cares for her, the way he looks at her when she's the only one in the room and includes her in everything. Also, the way they're each other's biggest supporter in everything they do. Everyone dreams of this kind of love that you both have. May you sure cherish it forever. Now, I want to tell you both how absolutely spectacular you both look today. I don't think I've ever seen a better looking couple. Let's give applause for how gorgeous the bride looks tonight. Before I wrap it up, I want to ask Westin and Chrissy to look around the room and take a little snapshot to remember this moment and soak it in. Soak in that all these people are here for you to celebrate your love. Now I want you both to look at each other and now soak in the fact that statistically you are looking at the person that will most likely murder you. Today, you start completely a new chapter of your lives. What can I say? Never forget the two most important replies. You're always right, dear. And okay, let's buy it. Love and cherish each other. I know you'll have challenges as relationships do, but know who's great about love and relationships and marriages. It's learning to grow together, caring and sharing, and lots of tenderness. And maybe a little bit of patience, or maybe a lot of patience. So let's raise our glasses to the powerful love of love that makes us all wonderful things happen. Please raise your glasses. And I wish you, sorry, I wish you both many years of love and happiness. Cheers to Westin and Kristin.
I'm not going to.
All right, so yeah, I'm not going to try to top that by any means whatsoever. Let me start. I'm the best man, Christian. If you don't know me yet, you're probably at the wrong wedding. Just letting y'all know. I can't say most of the stories. Westin told me I had to keep the PG, so I'm just going to have to kind of be pretty easy about that. You know, we're going to have to go pretty lenient. I wish the best to both of y'all, and cheers to Westin and Kristin. Come back in like 30 minutes, I'm going to tell every story I got.
All right, thank you so much. Appreciate it.
Let me say that in like 30 minutes.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, the cutting of the cake is done.